the Caribbean territory, you find the population is much, there are more black people than Caribbean people. And well, to be very honest, you see me, I am a bit racist. I don't like black people. That's one thing about it. I don't like black. I would rather be around with white people than black people.
Yeah.
Yeah, when I used to go to school, I used to sit on a bench with, and sometimes there were one or two black guys around me, and I would keep on cursing them until they come out by me, because I don't like to see my color, who I wouldn't want them to rest. I grew up with them, and after a while, when I become a national athlete, I become a national athlete when I went to St. Lucia. And I was in the same room with some black people, and that's where I become, like, acquainted to some black people and friends, I talk to black people. But when I was young, I was very racist. I never liked black people.
Mm-hmm.
Although sometimes you'll see me moving around with black people, but I do really like that.
So you think since you were a child, there have been more and more black people in the Caribbean territory?
Yeah, a lot of black people have been coming up in the Caribbean territory. You'll find a lot of black people coming up in the Caribbean territory. The life changed, the lifestyle has been changed, because people used to go and carry water in buckets and some of the crew they call bories, and they used to be eating in there in things they call calabash and things. But right now, you can see that, you know, they would go to hunt with bow and arrows, and right now, nothing like bow and arrows.
Is there any tension between the African people and the Cherokee people?
Okay, that used to be like before, that used to be like many years ago, but right now you see how the world is, things are changing right now, so the Carib people, it seems to me that they feel that they have to unite with the black African people. So, you know, no really tension, but you see they get their own territory, people cannot move in how they want, but what they can do, they can visit and stuff like that, but like staying in those areas, like people can't really go and like Negroes or white people can't go live their life in those places. Like if in case you're married to a Caribbean people as a Negro, you have to maybe take away or whatever, because they don't really allow like black people staying, like to get it all mixed up. But right now they're kind of united, they realize what life is all about, so everybody is like cooperating with each other right now.
Because the Carib people were here first, correct?
Yeah.
And then a lot of African people came in, and we've heard that there's just like, sometimes that there's tension, but I was wondering if you knew anything about that or had any feelings or...
Oh, well, I don't really know anything about that. I wouldn't really say, but like, as they say, the Caribs was working with something, so, and then the black people take over and things, so and... Certain black people always have like negative ways to Carib people, saying that Carib people this, Carib people that, and things. So, but I don't really have no kind of feeling about the black people and the Carib people, because if I had this type of feeling, maybe I would not feel Jefferson. I mean, he kind of more Carib than black people. His father, he have people in Marigold, he has people higher up Carib territory, so I don't really have no negative feelings towards the black people and all them kind of things. I don't really know.
Do you think that's more with the older generation than the younger?
Yes, I more think it's the older generation. So I more think like the older generation more feel that kind of worry about having things about black people and everything. But I mean, right now, Carib and black need to know, because right now we don't really have Carib. Carib people, they more go out and look for different people. So it's like we don't really have Carib now. That was like before. Everybody like now mix black and Carib together, and so they call it mixed race, and so we don't really have black.
So do kids ever fight at school?
Yeah.
What do they usually fight about?
Like sometimes they just fight about children and say bad things about them.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of stuff do they usually say about them?
they like they curse them.
Mm-hmm.
Also, like they have an experience all about sex. They keep on fighting.
They keep fighting. Are there ever any fights between yellow Caribs and Africans?
Yeah.
Yeah. How many fights do you think start because of that?
About three.
About three? Is that a big problem in the schools? No. What about after school, like with friends and stuff like that?
Yeah. We usually fight after school.
And what do they, same thing, like what do they fight about?
Like children fighting for different things, they fighting for girls.
Girls. What about adults? What do they usually fight about?
Like things like when they're drunk, they usually fight.
But is it ever over like race, like the two different groups?
No.
What's up? Do you feel that there are tensions between the people living in the Carib territory and the rest of the Dominica?
Yeah, yes, yes. Very. Because what you see, the blacks. The blacks always want to take over and want to control it.
They want to control even the Carib territory?
Yeah.
What do they do to try to control the territory?
Well, like they come, they want to like fight us down, and they want to sell all kind of things. They criticize everything we come to do. They oppose us. You know, they doesn't agree. They doesn't support us. They will disagree with us.
Is it difficult for you if you wanted to sell things outside of the Carib territory? Is it more difficult for you to sell them?
Yeah, more difficult. I don't believe we can do that outside.
Yeah.
Because in the territory we have the land belong to the Caribbean Council, the chief of this council, the six members. But beside the Caribbean territories, there is land. You have, if you need to build a house on the outside, you have to buy your land,
right,
have your land title, and then you all kind of thing that. And you have to have money to buy land. If it's 2 acres of land, you have to have the money to buy it. And like he does already to see both sides, we want to build outside our house up here.
Right.
So if we need to build a house now, we just go to the Caribbean chief and his council, and then we need a spot to build our home. So we're going to measure the spot, and then everything will be.
Will the Carib Council let blacks build their homes inside the territory?
Yes.
What about in schools? The schools are mixed? Your kids and everybody go to the same schools?
Yeah, more blacks than Caribbean.
Yeah. Is that ever a problem in schools?
Yeah, because sometimes, for example, now and then the blacks are always going to give the Caribbean, you know, the Caribbean then some kind of, you know, curse them down and say, you know, criticize them.
In America, it is the same way. We have these problems in our schools. Do you think the problems will ever end?
Well, I don't believe that will end.
No.
Because generation to generation coming up on this way.
It's difficult to change.
Difficult to change.
Yeah.